So let's look now at the reproductive system. Okay, so in this female here, we noted before the ovarian artery coming off. And remember, it has a very windy course here up to the ovary. We got a lot of fat within our ovarian bursa. Okay, so you can see there's the entrance into the ovarian bursa. The ovary is sitting right here. We have a suspensory ligament of the ovary. That's going to be important to break that down if we're doing an ovariohysterectomy. Okay, one thing to be careful with on the, I believe it is the left ovary, its vein is going to drain into the renal vein. Okay, so then we have the proper ligament here of the ovary attaching to the uterus. Let's see if we can even see the oviduct in here. Yeah, there's way too much fat in here, but I think I see it coursing along in here. So the oviduct is always hard when there's a lot of fat. Okay, we'll try that on another specimen, but the oviduct, remember, is going to be coursing in the mesosalpinx here. Okay. So we look at the mesentery suspending the uterus. That is going to be the mesometrium, and it's going to have a free edge here, which is the round ligament of the uterus, and you can see it going right down into the inguinal canal. So this vaginal process that goes through the inguinal canal and the bitch is unique to the bitch. And so these mesenteries here are the mesovarium. We have the mesosalpinx here, which is suspending the oviduct, and then the mesometrium, and all of this makes up the broad ligament. Okay, so we have uterine horns here, two uterine horns going into the body. And right here we can feel a firm cervix. Okay? So here we have another female specimen. This one we can see that the veins are injected. So we can see that ovarian vein coming over and emptying into the renal vein on the left side. Okay. So once again we have here the ovarian artery coming up to the ovary. Ovary is sitting right here. Once again, there's a lot of fat in the wall of the ovarian bursa. Here we can see the opening into that. So this portion here is the mesosalpinx. This is the mesovarium. We see that we have the suspensory ligament once more of the ovary and the proper ligament of the ovary right here. Okay, let's see over on this side. I've dug in a little bit here. I find the oviduct. Remember, in the canine, it's going to come from that opening of the ovarian bursa up and around and then down to the uterus. Okay, so we have mesosalpinx, mesovarium, then we have the mesometrium. And this free edge, once again, is the round ligament of the uterus. We see that going right down into the inguinal canal. We have this little vaginal process sticking out over here, which is unique to the canine. So our urethra then comes down here and goes into our vestibule. So we can see here, this is the urethral tubercle. There's the opening of the urethra. And so this portion up here is going to be the vagina. This portion back here, the common opening, is the vestibule. Within the vestibule, we can see the clitoral fossa and the clitoris in here. We have the labia of the vulva here. And if we follow the vagina cranially, so we follow it up here, and here we can see the cervix very well. And we have the fornix of the vagina around it here, through the cervix into the uterine body, and then we have our uterine horns. Okay, you can see very nicely here the uterine arteries. Okay.